In 1885, at the age of 8, he succeeded his father as Imam of the Shia Ismaili Muslims. Sir Sultan Mahmud Shah, Aga Khan III, was the 48th Imam of the Nizari Ismaili religion. He was born in Karachi, the capital of Sindh province in British India, in the 2nd of November 1877, to Aga Khan II and his third wife, Nawab, Aulia Shamsul Muluk, who was a granddaughter of Fateh Ali Shah Qajar of Persia. Sir Sultan Muhammad Shah was one of the founders and the first president of the All India Muslim League. Aga Khan called on the British Raj to consider Muslims to be a separate nation within India, the so-called two-nation theory. Even after he resigned as president of the All India Muslim League in 1912, he still exerted major influence on its policies and agendas. He was nominated to represent India to the League of Nations in 1932 and served as President of the League of Nations from 1937 to 38. The distinction of a Knight Commander of the Indian Empire (KCIE) was conferred upon him by Queen Victoria in 1897, and he was promoted to a Knight Grand Commander (GCIE) in the 1902 Coronation Honours List, and invested as such by King Edward VII at Buckingham Palace on 24 October 1902. He was made a Knight Grand Commander of the Order of the Star of India (GCSI) by George V in 1912, and appointed a GCMG in 1923. He received like recognition for his public services from the German Emperor, the Sultan of Turkey, the Shah of Persia and other potentates. During the three round table conferences in London from 1930 to 32, he played an important role to bring about Indian constitutional reforms. In 1934, he was made a member of the Privy Council and served as a member of the League of Nations from 1934 to 37, becoming the president of the League of Nations in 1937. After the creation of Pakistan, Aga Khan III, on the request of the then Prime Minister Faraz Khan Noon, purchased Gwadar from Oman and gifted it to Pakistan. Gwadar is now considered to be a game-changer for the region due to CPAC. Under the leadership of Sir Sultan Muhammad Shah, Aga Khan III, the first half of the 20th century was a period of significant development for the Ismaili community. Ismailis have marked the jubilees of their imams with public celebrations. The jubilees of Sir Sultan Muhammad Shah, Aga Khan III, are well remembered. During his 72 years of imamate, the community celebrated his Golden Jubilee in 1937, Diamond Jubilee in 1946 and Platinum Jubilee in 1954. In India and later in Pakistan, social development institutions were established, in the words of Aga Khan III, for the relief of humanity. Sir Sultan Muhammad Shah also introduced organizational forms that gave Ismaili communities the means to structure and regulate their own affairs. In 1905, he ordained the first Ismaili constitution for the social governance of the community in East Africa. The Aga Khan was deeply influenced by the views of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Along with Sir Syed, the Aga Khan was one of the backers and founders of the Aligarh University, for which he tirelessly raised funds for and donated large sums of his own money to. The Aga Khan himself can be considered an Islamic modernist and an intellectual of the Aligarh movement. Today, in large part due to the Aga Khan's reforms, the Ismaili community is one of the most progressive, peaceful, and prosperous branches of Islam. Sir Sultan Muhammad Shah married, on 2 November 1896, in Pune, India, to Shahzadi Begum, daughter of his uncle Aga Jahangir Shah. She was his first cousin and a granddaughter of Aga Khan I. He again married Cleope Teresa Mogliano in 1908. She died December 2, 1926. They had two sons, Prince Giuseppe Mahdi Khan, who died in February 1911, and Prince Ali Khan, who died in 1960. He married again, on 7 December 1929 in France, to Emelindre Caron, who bore his second son, Sadreddin, on January 17, 1933. On October 9, 1944, the Aga Khan married his fourth and last wife, Emel Yvette Labrousse, known as Om Habiba, the Begum Aga Khan. She converted to Islam and became known as Om Habiba. In 1954, her husband bestowed upon her the title Mata Salamat. Aga Khan III died on the 11th of July 1957. He succeeded as Aga Khan by his grandson Karim Aga Khan, who is the present Imam of the Ismaili Muslims. At the time of his death, his family members were in Geneva. A solicitor brought the will of the Aga Khan III from London to Geneva and read it before the family. These were the words of Aga Khan III. Ever since the time of my ancestor Ali, the first Imam, that is to say over a period of 1300 years, it has always been the tradition of our family that each Imam chooses his successor at his absolute and unfettered discretion from amongst any of his descendants. Whether they be sons or remote male issue, and in these circumstances and in view of the fundamentally altered conditions in the world in very recent years due to the great changes which have taken place, including the discoveries of atomic science, I am convinced that it is in the best interest of the Shia Muslim Ismailia community that I should be succeeded by a young man who has been brought up and developed during recent years and in the midst of the new age, and who brings a new outlook on life to his office as Imam. For these reasons, I appoint my grandson Karim, the son of my own son, Ali Salman Khan, to succeed to the title of Aga Khan and to the Imam and Peer of all Shia Ismailian followers.